Hi, my name is Victor. I'm the co-CEO and founder of Team Liquid. And we're here today to talk about FIFA. Team Liquid is entering FIFA. There's four main components to why we're specifically looking at FIFA right now. One, and probably most important, longevity of the game. It's been around for a long time. There's a loyal fan base, and that loyal fan base is waiting for their sport to grow bigger. Two is EA. Three, FIFA itself, not the game, but actually the global sports organization and all the clubs and teams that are behind that and that might be putting in their marketing power into the game. And the last one is Lasse himself, the player. When all the variables seem to be in the right place, that doesn't necessarily mean that we're actually ready to enter a scene. It's about picking up the right team that can represent the brand the right way or an individual player. And with Lasse, we believe to have found that.
My name is Lasse and I'm 21 years old and I come from Denmark. And I'm a sports fan all over, football, basketball. I grew up with my mom being a semi-professional footballer, I think. And so I've been a football person all my life. My favorite football team is Liverpool, no doubt. No doubt. I grew up in a small city in Denmark called Middelfart, but now I live in Fjellsted with only 200 citizens. So I'm basically all by myself in that city with my family. I don't know anyone else. Right now I'm not doing anything besides FIFA, but this summer I will start studying to become a teacher. So I'm looking forward to that. The two most important people in my life is my mom and my girlfriend. My mom is always there for me and has been there all of my life, and my girlfriend, she's just my girlfriend, so of course she's the most important person in my life. I got my first FIFA game in 2002 and I had like five versions in a row, but then I took a break, started playing some Pro Evolution Soccer, but in 2012 I bought FIFA again, and actually the year after I started playing competitively.
So when we engaged with Lasse and had our first meetings, it was immediately clear that he was an incredibly dedicated athlete. He not only does he have an attitude and spirit to be improving and get better at what he does, but he's already recognized as a top player today. So that's been very important in working with Lasse. And what really helped is that he had a lot of familiarity with Team Liquid already. He gets esports. He worked with a traditional sports team before that wasn't the greatest fit for him, and we're hoping to do everything we can to support him in his journey.
My fondest memory of competitive FIFA was my first event besides the Danish Championship, where I came up there as an unknown, a random, with all the big Danish guys, and I took home the victory, and I saw a lot of sad faces on them, and who is he, and stuff like that. That was just great, and that started the competitive FIFA in me. My biggest achievement as a FIFA pro must be my participation in the FIWC 2015, because it was 90 tough matches in the qualification, and I also had a lot of other Danish tournaments. I had my studying, and even besides that, I managed to win 90 games in a row and qualify myself. My FIFA playing style is just play counter and do a lot of skills. I'm not just a player, I'm also an entertainer. I, especially if I get in front, I like to do some showboating and cheer the crowd up.
I think if you look at the timelines of games that Team Liquid has supported, you'll find that the scenes we enter, we tend to stick with. Now, you know, it's not a perfect formula, you don't control all the variables involved with that, but we really do appreciate the longevity, and when we commit to something, we're intending to do so for the long run. One thing that's really interesting about FIFA is the fact that there's so many traditional sports organizations entering that space. You have the traditional sports teams, and you have the traditional esports teams, and FIFA is a game that they are entering it because it looks like football, and we're entering it because it's not football. And I think that's incredibly interesting.
My competitive goals is definitely both to win a Danish championship and to win a world championship. Because the skill gap between the best players in the world are so little at the moment, and I'm up there, so it's just about the margins and the concentration. What excites me the most is probably the the streaming and the money in it. Before, in 2016, 15, it was like $20,000 to the winner, and now it's $200,000 for the winner. So that just shows how much they wanted to get big, get as big as other esports. If I someday win a world championship, I still want to be even greater, because all the other will get stronger, and I have to also get stronger. So there is no goal. I will always just get better.
There's new games all the time, whereas most of the games that we're in, like Counter-Strike, Dota, League of Legends, they've been around between 7 and 15 years. And so that longevity, I think, is incredibly important if you want this to be a sport, and that's what we're trying to do.
Team Liquid, it means a lot to me to be the first FIFA player, because they have so many different players in different games, and that they wanted to choose me as their FIFA player, that's just huge. My expectations from Team Liquid is that they give me a lot more support than I got from my other teams, because Team Liquid's expectations to me are higher than I had before. So to get me there, we have to go there together. So that's why I need support. Well, what excites me the most is actually the past, because it's been existing for so long. But of course also the future, where I'll be a part of it, and hopefully a lot of championships to win.